Hey guys, thank you for coming back to my channel. I just want to share a quick inspirational video with you guys today. And I'm going to give you guys a morning prayer. And one of the prayers is, so teach us to number our days that we may apply our hearts unto wisdom. Psalms 90:12. We will all die. There is no magic pill or treatment that will allow you to live longer. Remember that your time is short and decide what you want to do with that time. You may want to consider using that time to seek and serve the Lord. That is the only truly lasting thing that we can do with our time. It is our best to use it, and God is gloried by it. So guys, we have to use our time wisely on earth. We have to seek God and go to God whenever we need his, whenever we need answers, because we have to know that we cannot do anything by ourselves. We can't do nothing alone. Anytime that we try to do anything alone, we're always going to fail, because he's our Father. He's our Heavenly Father. He's our spiritual Father. He's just our Father. He's our Creator. He made us who we are today. So we have to use God. And the best thing to do is always to have a communication and bond with God, so that you can know when you're doing wrong, and you know, you can turn to God. I have a bond with God, and I know when he's trying to get my attention. I know when I need to slack up on whatever that I may be doing, you know. But it's best to have a communication and a bond with God, and know not to just call on God in times of need. You have to go to God daily and speak to him and pray and give him time and just worship God, guys. I'm going to give you guys a prayer, and a prayer is going to be, Heavenly Father, help me to remember that my days are short. Don't let me waste my time on meaningless things. Let me spend my time doing things that matter, like serving you and worshiping you. So we want to worship God in his name, and we want to serve God. Give me an internal clock that reminds me of any limited time, and give me the endurance to serve you with my time. In Jesus' name, amen. So guys, we have to always remember that God is on our side. Anytime that you feel hopeless, you feel like things are not going well in your life, or you just feel lost and you feel defeated and you feel like you can't go on, always turn to God. If you have to remove some people out of your life to do that, to get that communication and bond with God, do what you need to do, because he will restore the right people in your life. You know, some people are in our life for a season. Some people are in our life for a reason. So we just have to know the kind of people that we want around us, and allow them to grow with you and you grow with them. So God is always going to be by our side. He's always going to be there for us when we need him. We just have to ask, and you know, we'll receive our blessings. Always, guys, always try to repent too. Like if you did something that you knew wasn't right, and you just have to repent and ask God for forgiveness. He's a forgiving God. He will forgive us of any and everything that we do. We just have to ask. You know, God is our best friend. And he wants us to use him. I'm going to go to my Bible. And one second, please. I want to share with you guys something. And one second, please. God is our best friend, y'all. He would never leave us or forsake us. He will always be by our side through thick and thin. No matter if you feel like you have nobody in your corner, you have God always in your corner. God is always willing to help you get through any and everything that you need to get through. Use your time to help others. You know, give unto others as God will want you to do that. He wants us to help others. Sow your seed into the world. God is always going to show us and lead us and guide us in the right direction. Sometimes we may ask for things and don't get it at the moment and get all frustrated and feel like, you know, you just don't know where to go, where to turn. But sometimes we have to know that some things that we ask for are not meant for us at the moment, because it's on God's timing. So if we want it right then, maybe it's not our time to have it, you know. So we just have to be patient and wait. Maybe God has something else in store better for us, that he put a roadblock in front of us and said, you know, this is not what I want you to have right now. You know, I want you to have what was in your heart and what you desired when you first came to me and asked me for it. So if it's anything that you want, you know, be sincere to God when you ask for it. And if that prayer doesn't come through, don't jump to something else and, you know, put your thoughts and hopes into that, because sometimes we may not get it because that's not what we ask God for. And sometimes we have to understand that we have to be grateful for the small things in order to get the big things. So we have to be grateful for what we have and appreciate what we have and know that what we have is what God has given us. So we can't flop all around. He blesses you with a new car and then you say, oh, I want another new car or a different kind of car, when he just blessed you with a new car of your choice most of the time. You can't be wishing and hoping for, let's just say, a new home, when he's blessed you to have a roof over your head. You can ask him, God, could you please rearrange my living situations and allow me to, you know, if it's in your will, one day in life, bless me with a new home. But say, God, I'm grateful and I'm thankful for the roof that's over my head. Because some people don't have a nice car to drive around in. Some people don't have a dependable vehicle to ride around in. Some people don't have a roof over their head. So we have to be grateful and thank God for what we do have. And when God see that we are appreciating what he did give us, he's always going to bless us with better and lead us in the right direction and put us on the right path to what we want. But we have to be grateful and show him that I'm grateful for what you did just give me, God. One second, guys. We have to tell God that we are grateful. And guys, always remain humble in everything that we do. We have to remain humble and always look at it as God don't like when we brag or boast, okay? He doesn't like that. But when you're a child of God and you're blessed, from my perspective, I like to look like I'm blessed. You're supposed to look like you're a child of God, you know? At least that's in my opinion. I like to look like I'm blessed. I like to look like, you know, God is doing great things in my life, because he is doing great things in my life, and I am blessed, and we all are blessed. You know, it's a blessing every morning to just wake up in the morning and open our eyes, and no matter what we may be going through in our bodies or no matter how the outside world is, waking up by itself is a blessing. God keeping you and your family safe and protected throughout the night and having his angels around you as you sleep and keeping you protected is a blessing. Some people not able to wake up every morning. Some people may wake up in the morning and can't get out of bed. So we got to thank God for allowing us to use our legs and our feet, all of our limbs. Every morning we get out of bed, thank God for it. Hallelujah. We got to just say, God, I thank you for even allowing me to be able to get up and walk around my home, go to work, drive a car. Because some people can't do those things, guys. So we have to be grateful. And even the people who can't do it, and if you're on my channel and it's something you can't do, you can't get out of bed, Ask God to give you the strength one day to be able to do those things, because he'll help you. God is a healing God. He heals us all. He knows our strengths. He knows our weakness. God knows everything we desire before we even go to him and ask him for it. So if you is that person that can't get around your house or you use a wheelchair, be grateful still that you can do those things. If you are bedridden and you have help, you have a caregiver, be grateful that you do have a caregiver, you know? And be thankful that you did wake up another day, no matter what we may be going through. I was a home health aide before COVID. And I went to many people's homes, the elderly, who needed assistance with everyday living. They couldn't get out of bed and get a shower. They couldn't get out of bed and fix their breakfast. They couldn't get out of bed to get their medication, to make a fresh cup of coffee, or go to the grocery store. I was their caregiver. I was the one that was helping these people do these daily livings. Some of them could get out of bed but couldn't drive a car. So I was the person that come to their home and take them to their doctor's appointments, take them grocery shopping, take them to go see a movie. I was that person when they didn't have any family members who will go into their home and be a companion for them and talk to them and pray with them. You know, God sends his angels in all forms, shapes, and sizes, guys. God will send you a message through anything, guys. You can be looking at TV and get a message. You know, he will make it his business to get a message out to you if you're seeking an answer to something, if you pray to God about a certain thing. He's not going to leave us lost. He's not going to leave us wondering. You just have to believe and trust in God that whatever you ask of him, he's going to do exactly what he said he's going to do. And all it takes is faith the size of a mustard seed, guys. That's all you need. Faith the size as a mustard seed, guys. And God is going to hold our hand through everything. No matter what we're going through, he's going to be there for us. And he's going to lead us down the right path to righteousness. So, yeah, don't be afraid. Don't be afraid. Don't be embarrassed to say, God, I need you. I love you. I want your love. I want your presence. Don't be afraid. Sometimes I could be walking in the grocery store, guys, and I'll say, thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, God. I could be at work and say, thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, God. You know, thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, God. Thank you, God, for giving me the air in my body, for having me to be healthy today, to get on this YouTube channel and make a video. Who knows? This video may have touched somebody. You know, just thank God for having the air in our bodies to do the things that we need to do in life, to even be able to get up in the morning. Okay, let's see. Okay, guys, I want to share something with you. It's but when they saw him walking upon the sea, they supposed it had been a spirit and cried out, for they all saw him and were troubled. And immediately he talked with them and said unto them, be of good cheer, it is I. Be not afraid. So I'm going to give you an inspirational. It is incredible to think about Jesus walking on the water. It is quite incredible to imagine seeing a person out of the water. Of course, you would figure it's a ghost. Then Jesus telling them not to be afraid. Incredible. Jesus is capable of doing anything. Believe in his name and experience his greatness, guys. Lord, you make mighty miracles. You do it with ease. It is in your nature to be miraculous. You make simple moments amazing. You can walk on water. You can move mountains. You make the weak feel strong, and you make the strong feel weak before you. Thank you for your might and your goodness. I love to hear of the mighty ways. In Jesus' name, amen. So guys, we have to be grateful for the things that God are doing for us in our life. And God is just an amazing God. And to believe in God and know that, you know, He's real is amazing. God is definitely real. God has definitely put me into some situation. He didn't put me in any situations. I'm going to rephrase that. I have been in situations in my life when I had to turn to God. And as I prayed to God, I knew that it was Him who got me through what I was going through in life. It could be anything that we go through. If we believe that He's real, He'll work it out for our good. I want to share something else with you guys. One moment, please. Let's see what I'm going to share with you guys today. Okay. Ye shall walk after the Lord your God, and fear Him, and keep His commandments, and obey His voice, and ye shall serve Him and cleave unto Him. Okay. Although this verse is a bit, okay, that verse came from Deuteronomy 13:4. Although this verse is a bit contradictory with other verses, the message is clear. Obey the Lord's commands. Do this and you shall have nothing to fear, guys. Just obey God's commands and you won't fear anything. Powerful and awesome God, I shall obey your commandments. Forgive me though, O Lord, for I am a weak man that is easily tempted by evil. Deliver me from evil so that I may fulfill my obligations to you. I pray that my strength shall be increased with each challenge overcome, and now that I can love you more than I do now. I shall commit myself totally to serve of you, my God, for you are the one and only. Amen. So guys, we have to serve God. And when I say serve God, I serve God with my whole heart. I enjoy worshiping God. God will deliver us from evil in any trying times. We just have to ask God. And like I said before, ask God for forgiveness. Ask God to forgive you of your sins. Repent, guys. Always repent. Obey the laws of God. Obey His commandments to the best of our ability. And sometimes we're not perfect. That's why we have to turn to God. And if you feel like you've did something that wasn't of God, ask God for forgiveness. Ask God to repent and forgive you of your sins, guys. I'm going to share something else with you guys. Let's see. I want to tell you guys to seek God and not evil, that ye may live, and so the Lord, the God of hosts, shall be with you as you have spoken. And that is coming from Amos 5:14. God continually asks us to seek the good, to speak and praise it. The reason most simply is that to find the good involves finding a part of God. For all that is ultimately good are all things He has created, which are living in harmony with His will. Spend some time today to stop and ask yourself, what today has been good? What today has been good to you? For me, today has been good of me and my family waking up this morning. We was able to have air in our bodies, and the kids are off to school, my husband off to work. You know, we're grateful for those things. The more you look, the more you find. The more you see, the more God gives with you. Lord of heaven, gracious Jesus, Give us today our daily bread and share with us your majesty and beauty. For I know your God works. No, for I know your good works here on earth are everywhere as gifts for all to praise and enjoy. Help in bringing me closer to you, Lord, by opening my eyes and seeing your grace and beauty in every step along the way. So God, just be grateful for that. So I'm not going to make this video too long. I just wanted to come on here and share some things with you guys. If you like this video, give this video a thumbs up. If you want to leave me a comment in the comment section, go ahead and drop a few comments down. Turn on your post notifications so that you know when I'm coming back on to my channel and you can be blessed or, you know, get whatever content me and my family is going to put out for that day. But like I say, I'm going to end it with, guys, just be of good cheer. You know, today, go and help someone. You know, God would want us to do that. And remember, God loves you. And there's nothing that we can do by ourselves. All of our help comes from the Lord Jesus Christ, God. And we have to just continue to stay in prayer and continue to worship God, continue to learn God, and you could be a messenger for him, you know. So I'm going to leave you guys with that. So until next time, guys, I'll see you in my next video. Bye. Be blessed.